Alright, in this video we'll do another example of expressing a complex number in polar form. So here we're just going to do -4i. So if we graph -4i, you can think about that as being 0 minus 4i, if you want to see the real part in there. So all we're doing in this case is the real part is 0, so we're just going down to -4. So there would be our complex number, just kind of sitting on the, you know, the negative y-axis. Well, we can always go back and just start using our formulas in this case. It says what we need to do is we have to figure out the value for r, we have to think about the angle theta that's being made here. Alright, so again, our complex number z is 0 minus 4i. You know, the modulus is just the length, so you can always use Pythagorean theorem, but in this case, I think it's pretty easy to see that the length of this, or the modulus, would simply equal 4. Okay, likewise, I think theta is pretty easy to come up with, since it's sitting here on the negative y-axis. So halfway would be 180, another 90, we would be sitting at 270 degrees. So now we're pretty much there. We just have to fill in our formula. Again, it says z would be equal to, it says r, which is our r value, again, is just the modulus. So our r value is just 4. And then we'll take cosine of 270 degrees plus I times sine of 270 degrees. And now we've taken our complex number 0 minus 4i, and now we have it in polar form.